Today I'm going to show you the latest updated version of Topaz Gigapixel AI, which I use to upscale or enlarge my images in Photoshop. Now I've already made a video demonstrating in real time this app's ability to enlarge your images whilst vastly improving the quality at the same time. And I'm going to provide a link to view this video at the end of this review. Topaz have just updated their Gigapixel AI software to version 6.1, and you'll find the results even better than before due to the addition of a brand new face recovery feature. This does exactly what it suggests by finding faces in the image and automatically improving and enhancing them to a degree that's simply stunning. Normally, when you enlarge an image featuring people, the larger you make the image, the lower the resolution and faces start to blur out. Well, not anymore, as Gigapixel AI automatically recognizes facial features, and unlike other programs that work by simply enlarging the pixels, Gigapixel compares your image with millions of other images in its data bank and literally fills in the missing details that cause the usual blocking and poor resolution. And it's not just faces. The app can be used in almost all genres of photography, including portrait, landscape, architecture, and of course, my own personal preference, wildlife and nature. It simply makes poor images better and turns good images into great images. However, I've also worked out another use that I've been experimenting on for the last day or two with incredible results. I've been enlarging, improving and restoring my historic family images that have been lying around collecting dust for many years, and Gigapixel has restored them beautifully. So I'm now going to demonstrate again in real time how I restored a 60-year-old family portrait by just pressing a couple of buttons. You really need to see this to believe it. Okay, so I've opened up an image in Photoshop. This is an image from the 60s, I believe. It's my lovely mum and her mum. Basically, this is a photograph like many others I'm sure we've all got at home that's sat in a cupboard somewhere. It's been in an album and it's looking a little bit sad and kind of worse for wear. So I'm hoping that this incredible new face recovery AI, which is part of the Gigapixel AI 6.1 upgrade, will do wonders for this image and make it a much more clear and sharp image. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to open up the image in Gigapixel, and that just takes a second or two to come in. Now in Gigapixel, in fact, in all my Topaz products, I tend to open up what's called the comparison view. If you looked it over to the right-hand side here, there's something called an AI model. That's basically five different models that actually, it models the image down to certain kind of criteria. There's standard, lines, art and CG, low resolution and very compressed. And what's good about this is that these four boxes allows you to immediately compare one against the other so that you can actually find the best one to work on. It takes a little while to come in. As you can see, these bars are coming across here, the blue bars are where it's rendering, and it will show you at the end of that exactly how it would look using that particular model. If there's a model that you're not keen on and you want to see the fifth one that's available, what you need to do is just highlight the one that you think is not the best on it, which I think is probably art and CG, and the one that we've got missing is the very compressed. So we click on very compressed over here on the right hand side, and that now comes in on the bottom left here, and you can see it's rendering. So you can now see, and you now can make a decision of which one you prefer. Now this is where personal preference steps in. Some people like to leave it as natural as possible. So other people like to have it a bit more sharp. This is going to be a personal preference. So what I do may not be what you would do, but I'll tell you something. In this program, there will be some measure that you can use on here which would be pleasing to your eye. Now, of the four that I've got here, to my eye, looking at on my screen, the one that I think could potentially be the better of the four is, in fact, the standard. So I'm going to click on standard, yeah. And what I'm going to do then, I'm going to take it into the single view. You use these little boxes at the top here for the different views you can have. Now on the single view, it's rendering again at the bottom. So if you wait till that renders, you'll then be able to press on the original button here, see the original image, and you see the rendered one. Now I'm hoping you can see that, but that's pretty impressive. There's another way you can view, and that's split view. It's all personal preference here. Again, it's going to render at the bottom here, but once you've done that, he'll use his line, and you can move it back and forwards just to see what effect it's having on the image, okay? Then there's a side-by-side view. Again, it's going to render down here, and this will give you another easy way to show the difference between the original and the rendered version there. And for me, I already know, you know, that the standard is the one that I'm going to be going with, so I can easily go back to single view. Now, this is a good time when you go back to single view. Again, remember, it's going to render for a little while. It's doing a lot of work in the background there. So this is where you can actually go into settings, and you can fine-tune the image itself. Again, every time you make a change, then it will re-render. On the settings, you can suppress noise or remove blur. I'm quite happy with that at the moment. The only thing I might do, actually, if you notice my grandma's face there on there, a little bit blurred on the top. Now I could fix that in Photoshop, but I'm curious to see what would happen if I just change the recovery strength to see whether that just sharpens that up a wee bit. So we'll just move that up maybe 10 points to see how that affects the image. And if that's okay, then I'll probably keep that and use it. And any other little tweaks, there's little things that need fixing here in my mum's hairline and little dots and bits of scrap. Now that to me is pretty good. If we look at the original and then we look at that, I can't believe you cannot be pretty impressed with that. Now, all I need to do then is I need to go down and press the apply button. It will then go back into Photoshop, and you can then make the other changes that you need to do to make it perfect. I will save, and I'll continue to be an advocate for Topaz for all the apps that they have, all of which have improved my photography tremendously and given me greater opportunities to process better images. I'll put a link below, by the way. I will remind you that you can go onto their webpage. Their webpage is where you can download a copy of this free of charge to play with for 30 days. They even give you their stock images that they've worked on, which will show you as a demonstration on their site. And they give you the settings that they used to actually achieve quality of the photograph, which is astonishing. That means that you can try it for nothing. You can use their settings. You can see that there's been no other manipulation and that it does what it says on the box at the end of the day. It's a stunning piece of kit. And I tell you what, you're going to have an awful lot of fun getting your old photographs up and bringing them back to life. So you see, that's just one of the features of this program you can use to enhance your photographs. And you know, if it works this well on older images, just imagine what it can do to improve today's images. Well, you can find out for yourself by using the link below to download and try it for 30 days, absolutely free of charge. And I'm so impressed that I've finally relented and become an affiliate for Topaz, so that I can save money for anyone downloading and buying the program by using the unique download link in the description below. I'm providing links to all Topaz apps that I use myself. And by using the link with the promo code FRIENDS15, you'll automatically receive a 15% discount, and I get a small thank you from Topaz, which helps with the running costs for the channel. So, as always, thanks for watching, and see you next time on the Better Photography Channel.